The next ayah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, the translation would be, you alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help. Now, if we look at what is mentioned here first, it's ibadah. Ibadah is mentioned first. And then what's mentioned? Seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is like a divine lesson that Allah is teaching us. All of Fatiha, all of Quran is a lesson for us. But look at the ordering that Allah has put. That Allah does not put anything in His book randomly. There's a benefit for us from in this. Allah is telling us ibadah is coming first, and then seeking help. Let's take an example of a friend of ours, or someone that we might know, that the only time they come to us is when they're in need of us, when they're asking for help. What kind of friend is that? Or if you were to look at a son or a child, that the only time they go to their parents is when they need something. What kind of relationship is that? It's not a very strong relationship. It's almost as if you're just using that person. But from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we call upon Him, even if we have not been obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if we have transgressed certain bounds, Allah is still so merciful that He would respond. That He could respond to this person, even if they are a sinner. But we know that there are certain things that can prevent our du'as. So we have to be careful and make sure we don't transgress the bounds of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there could be certain things that prevent our prayers from being answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah teaches us, be obedient first. Learn to pray and come to me as you're supposed to come to me. As a humble slave, an obedient, worshipping slave, and then ask from me. That don't just come to me when you're in need. Rather, be in a constant relationship, a constant connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when times of difficulty come, you already have that relationship. Opposed to always running to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only when you're in need. But when you're in times of happiness, you have no connection with Allah. When you're in times of joy, you don't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, only when there's a calamity or difficulty, then when you pray to Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, come, please help me now. So we want to learn from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this methodology, that pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be obedient to Him, and then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His help. And also we have to realize that we must come to the understanding of what our purpose is. And Allah is teaching us here. The very first purpose of Allah saying is إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, that's ibadah. That in this life we're here to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next thing is that while we're in this ibadah, while we're in this world struggling and striving in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're gonna have to ask for His help. Because difficulties will come upon us. We will have shaitan's whispers come to us. There will be different things that will tempt us and will call us from this side and that side. And that's when we have to be constantly asking Allah for His help. And also if we look at this ayah, it is not a command. We don't say, Allah is not saying over here, worship me and ask me for help. Rather, Allah is teaching us here, come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your own accord, in your own obedience. Come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And on top of that, you see that if you look at the language of Surah Al-Fatiha so far, it has been in third person. It has been, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, or the All Merciful, the Ever Merciful. And then what? All praise and thanks is due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. It's all third person, right? We're talking about Allah, third person. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the All-Merciful, the Ever-Merciful. Maliki Yawm Al-Din, Master of the Day of Judgment. So what would flow in this order, if we look at it logically from the language, it should have been Iyyahu Na'budu, Him alone we worship. But rather it shifted. And rather it's become a conversation now, it's become a dialogue where we're saying Iyyaka Na'budu, You alone, Ya Allah, we worship. And think about this, we're saying we worship. We're saying we worship and we ask for help, not I worship and I ask for help. And you could say, okay, that makes sense because when we're in jama'ah prayer, we're all as a group. But when we're by ourselves, what do we say? We don't say, إِيَّاكَ أَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ أَسْتَعِينَ. We don't say that you alone I worship and you alone I ask for help. Rather, it's supposed to be a sense that we come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a group because we're too shy to have that conversation one-on-one. We come humbled. Like if you could take an example of maybe someone you're shy of, you say, come on, come with me. I can't go and talk to this person unless you come with me. You know this person a little bit better maybe. That with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the King of all kings, we come in this shy manner. Humbled that we cannot just say that I come to you, Ya Allah. Rather, it is us collectively we come to you. And also it gives us a sense of having jama'ah. Having a sense of an ummah, being together. And having, worshipping Allah as a group. And asking Allah's help as a group. Not just I'm on my own and this person's on their own. A lot of people will say that this is my religion, leave me to it, leave me to how I worship. Rather, no, we're an ummah. We function as a group. The next ayah we have, Ihdina Siratul Mustaqim. The translation for this is, guide us to the straight upright path. Guide us to the straight upright path. And the word Ihdina, or the verb Ihdina, it's a command verb, but we don't say here we're commanding Allah. Rather, we're making dua to Allah. We're seeking this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we're saying, Ya Allah, please guide us. Guide us to what kind of path? As-sirat. Which is what kind of path? It's a very wide path that many people can take. And it is the main path that all other paths lead to. And it is wide and straight. Mustaqim, something that is qa'im, is something that is straight up. That is, it's vertical. So it's a path that leads to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala away from this dunya. That it is a path that we are asking Allah to guide us to, and not just any kind of guidance. It's the type of guidance that, if you look at the language, it's a type of guidance where we're saying, give us direction to the path, as well as guide us along the way to the path until we reach the goal. So that actually comes in the language that if you say ihdina ila, it's to give directions. Ihdina li, it means guide us all the way there. So when neither of those are mentioned, because it's not ihdina li and not ihdina ila, it's ihdina siratul mustaqim. Both meanings are applied in that. That we're asking Allah to guide us to the path, show us what the path is, and along the way, keep us committed to guidance. Keep us committed to guidance that whenever we do make a mistake, Ya Allah, bring us back to that path and keep us on that path. So we're asking Allah to guide us in a way that we know what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know what displeases Him so we can stay away from it. And we can constantly be in the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the formula, that it's not by our actions that we enter Jannah. It is rather by what? The Prophet ﷺ says that it is by the mercy of Allah, by the fadl of Allah, by His pleasure that He will enter who He wills. They asked the Prophet ﷺ, even for you, Ya Rasulullah, that even you will not be granted Jannah by your actions alone? He says, not even me. Only if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to wrap me in His mercy, then I would be entered into Jannah. So we act in this world not calculating our actions and our good deeds. Yes, okay, I got the Jannah marker, I passed it, I'm good to go. That's not how it works. Rather, we keep doing what pleases Allah, and we stay away from what displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we keep working according to it in hopes that Allah will be pleased with us and He will enter us into Jannah. So the last ayah of the surah is Sirat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim. Sirat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wa al-dhalin. So Allah is telling us to ask for the path of those who He favored. That we're asking now, we're taught to ask for the path of those who already succeeded. Because every one of us that is in this life right now, all of us are in the struggle. None of us can say that we have accomplished it and we've already gotten the goal, I can relax now. That I have accomplished what I needed to. Rather, Allah is teaching us that our real role models are the ones that have already succeeded. They've passed with flying colors. And Allah will talk about them in the Quran. He will tell us who are these righteous people. That they are the prophets. They are the righteous. They are the shuhada. They are the people that are trustworthy, truthful. They are these people who worked hard. And He will show us what made them successful in the Quran. So we're asking Allah for guidance in this book. And what does He do? He says that the rest of this book, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا غَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدَى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This book is the book of guidance. So we ask in this dua, this part of Fatiha, guide us. Allah says, this is the answer to your guidance, this book. We're saying, guide us to the path of those who you favored. Allah saying, here is the path of who I favored. And here is their path, and this is how they achieve their path. And last thing we say is, not the path who has earned anger, who is the recipients of anger, and not those who have gone astray. And Allah shows us who are those people who have gone astray and what led them astray. That Allah details for us the past nations who have gone astray, tells us the detail of the story of Fir'aun, the arrogance of Fir'aun, the nifaq of certain people, the nifaq of certain groups, and we go into detail. And Allah shows us, literally the dua is answered in the rest of the Quran to show us how to live our lives. And now if you look at the last portion, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. This is actually a case study that the Prophet ﷺ said that these are referring to two groups that came before us. That Allah had given them the message, but they had gone astray for two different reasons. So now we don't say, oh, okay, it's just those groups. It has nothing to do with us. Rather, we say, what was the reason that both of those groups went astray? And what of those qualities or characteristics are found in us? And we get rid of those characteristics and those qualities. The very first group is غير المغضوب عليهم. غير المغضوب عليهم, yes. The first group is those who earned anger. And you see a lot of translations, it says that they earned the anger of Allah. Not the path of those who earned the anger of Allah. Rather, the more correct translation is those who earned anger. Because in the Arabic, it's not there. It's not saying that Allah is mad at them. What that shows is that these people are recipients of anger, not just from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have anger of Allah is enough, but it is the anger of the righteous, the anger of even their own group maybe, the anger of the malaika, the anger of the creation around them, and the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. It also shows us that Allah did not even want to be mentioned with this group. You can see that's even like a sign of His anger, that He does not even want to be mentioned with this group, that my anger is upon you. Rather, it says, these people are the recipients, the objects of anger. And what was the reason that they earned anger? Now this is where we should be paying very close attention. The reason why they earned anger in this life is because they had the proper knowledge, yet they did not implement it. They changed that knowledge. And they went against the knowledge they knew. They knew what was correct, but they went against it.